Hi, good morning. Myself Triveni, working as assistant professor at Raghavendra Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research, Raipur, at NMS Anantapur. In this lecture, I am going to explain nomenclature of benzene and its derivatives. It's my first lecture. Under here, depending upon the arrangement of the carbon atoms in their structure, organic compounds are broadly categorized into two types. These are alicyclic, acyclic or open chain compounds. The second one is cyclic or closed chain compounds. Coming to the acyclic or open chain compounds, these are further categorized into two types, straight chain compounds and branched chain compounds. Coming to the straight chain compounds, here the carbon atoms are attached with each other to form a straight chain, example butane, pentane, nonane, etc. Coming to the branched chain compounds, the carbon atoms are attached with each other and also it forms the sum of the branches, and these are known as branched chain compounds. One of the example, 4-methylpent-2-ene, etc. Coming to the cyclic compounds, these are further categorized into two types, homocyclic compounds and heterocyclic compounds. Homocyclic compounds are also two types, alicyclic compounds, aromatic compounds. Alicyclic compounds contain one or more all carbon rings which may be either saturated or unsaturated but do not have the aromatic character. Example, cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclohexane. And next one is aromatic compounds. Aromatic compounds consist of conjugated planar ring systems accompanied by delocalized pi electron clouds, that is alternating double bonds and single bonds. They are known as aromatics or arene compounds. Example, toluene, benzene, etc. And naphthalene also comes under aromatic ring. And next, coming to the heterocyclic compounds. Heterocyclic compounds have at least two different elements in the ring. Example, pyridine, pyrrole, furan, thiophene, etc. Next, coming to the nomenclature part, any substitution are present in the parent chain means we have to indicate as in a prefix and suffix. The suffix is the principal group, it has the highest priority, and prefix is then a substituent, it has the lowest priority. Next, we will see that nomenclature for the monosubstituted benzene compounds. Monosubstituted benzenes are named with the substituent as in a prefix. We will see the examples for this. For example, in this structure, it is in a fluorobenzene, and here fluoro group as in a substituent. For the substituent, we have to give the lowest priority. And likewise, we have to name the chlorobenzene, bromobenzene, nitrobenzene, etc. And if you see some other examples, example alkyl benzenes. Alkyl benzenes, for example, here methyl group is attached here to the benzene ring. So it is known as methyl benzene. The common name for the methyl benzene is toluene. And next one is ethyl benzene. Ethyl group is attached to the benzene ring. Likewise, here isopropyl moiety is attached to the benzene ring. Generally, we can say it is in a cumene. Okay. And next, coming to the in benzene, one of the hydrogen is replaced with bromine, is named as bromobenzene, and we seen in above the class. Then how to write the structure of bromobenzene, whether which structure is correct one, means we can write any structure among those structures. Why? Because bromine is in a only a single substitution. We can say it is in a monosubstitution. This monosubstitution, it may occupy any of the six positions of the benzene ring. So that's why we can prefer any of the structure. So all these structures are correct for the bromobenzene. And next one is some of the benzene derivatives have currently accepted common names. So without IUPAC names, we can also call it as in a common name. One of the example, so we seen in previous slide, that is toluene. Toluene also known as toluene, IUPAC name is methyl benzene, or the common name is toluene. And likewise, OH group is attached to the benzene ring. We can say it is an phenol. And amino group is attached to the benzene. We can say it is an aniline. Likewise, carboxylic acid is attached to the benzene. The common name for this structure is benzoic acid. Likewise, sulfonyl moiety is attached to the benzene. We can say it is in a benzene sulfonic acid. And next one, if dye substitutions are there, then how we have to name the benzene? And whenever dye substitutions are there, we have to write ortho, meta, para positions. So which one is ortho means to the main substitution. Assume that it is a main substitution. The first one is a main substitution. The second substituent will be attached to this carbon atom. We can say it is an ortho carbon atom. These two positions indicates the ortho positions. And to the ortho position, the next carbon atom, this carbon atom indicates the meta position. And opposite to this also, it is in a meta position. And opposite to the first substitution component, we can write also this one. This is the para position. So these are the substitutions, ortho, meta, para positions. Next, coming to the example. In this example, I taken both substitutions are CH3. So this is the first substitution, this is the second substitution. And whenever two CH3 moieties are attached to the benzene, we can say it is in a xylene. So depending upon the position of the second CH3 group, we can name as an ortho, meta or para. So in the second CH3 group is attached at ortho position, so it is an ortho xylene. In the second example, the second CH3 group is attached at meta position, we can say it is an meta xylene. In the third one, the second CH3 group is attached at para position, so it is in a para xylene. Or we can write IUPAC name also for this. Here to the first substitution, we have to give the first number 1, and you know this is the carbon number 2 and 3, 4, 5, 6. Likewise, we have to give the numbering. So the substitutions are present at first and second position. We have to write 1, 2, and 2 methyl groups are present, so we have to indicate as in a di, and 2 are the methyl groups are present, so it is in a dimethyl, and these are attached to the benzene, so we have to write benzene. So the name of the component is 1, 2 dimethyl benzene. Likewise, we have to give the numbering for the next component, that is 1, this structure is 1, 3 dimethyl benzene. The position is 1 and this is the third position. And in the next structure is here it is the first carbon atom, then and this is the fourth carbon atom. Here we can give the numbering either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Why? Because in any direction the second substitution will get the fourth number. Okay, so in the second example we have to give the numbering clockwise direction. Why? Because the second substitution should get the lowest number. And in the case of first example also, the numbering it is in a clockwise direction. Why? Because the second substitution should get the lowest number. And next one is, when common names are used, the substituent which is responsible for the name. For example, in case of toluene, the main substituent is CH3 group. In case of phenol, the substituent is OH. So to these atoms, we have to consider, and when these groups are attached to the benzene, to that carbon atom, we have to give the first position. So one of the example, we will see one of the example here. Benzene is attached with the CH3 moiety. We know that the name of the common name is toluene, and the chloro group is attached at the ortho position. So we can say ortho chloro toluene. And other name is, we have to give the numbering to the first carbon, to the substituent attached carbon atom, we have to give the first number, and we have to give the second number at this position. Why? Because the second substituent should get the lowest number. Likewise, we have to give the numbering and thereby the IUPAC name for this structure is 2-chlorotoluene. Likewise, we have to give the numbering for the remaining structures. One more example, it is in a meta-bromotoluene. Bromo group is attached at the meta position, or we can say third position, 3-bromotoluene. And if you take one of the other example here, the phenol. So OH group is attached to the benzene, it is in a phenol. Then chloro group is attached at the para position. So we can indicate as in a para chlorophenol or 4-chlorophenol. So this is the one of the rule. And next, coming to the whenever two different substitutions are present, these two substitutions are different, then they are usually put in alphabetical order. We will see the example. In this case, there is no common names. Two different substitutions are present. One substitution is chlorine, another substitution is bromine. In the second example, one substitution is ethyl group, one substitution is propyl group. So in this case, how we can name the component means, according to alphabetical order we have to write the name. So in the case of bromine and chlorine, according to alphabetical order I am following A, B, C, D likewise. Then here B will come first, so we have to give the first number for this carbon atom, and the second substitution should get the lowest number. That's why I am giving the numbering anti-clockwise direction, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So the name of the component here, it is 1-bromo-2-chlorobenzene. We will see the second example here, and when you see this example here, ethyl group is there, propyl group is there. According to alphabetical order, E will come first. So to this atom we have to give the first number, 1 and 2 and 3, 4, 5, 6. So here I am giving numbering clockwise direction. So the name of the component is 1-ethyl-3-propyl-benzene. So this is the correct numbering. Then we should not write 1-chloro-2-bromo-benzene for this. We should not give the first number for the chloro group. So it is in wrong one. And likewise here also, we should not give the 1-propyl-3-ethyl-benzene. Why? Because according to alphabetical order, we have to give the numbering. These two are the wrong IUPAC names. These two are correct IUPAC names. Coming to the next rule, naming of the polysubstituted benzenes. So whenever two or more substitutions are there, these compounds are known as polysubstituted benzenes. So for example, here 3-chloro groups are attached. At that time, how we can give the numbering means, the sum of the attached or sum of the substituents must get the lowest number. So here in this case, I given 1, 2, 4 trichlorobenzene. So when you see the sum of the substitution, the chlorine, first chlorine is attached at the first position, so one place. The second chlorine is attached at the second position, so two place. And third chlorine group is attached at the fourth position, so one place, two place, four. So total sum of the substitutions is 7. So that's why I taken this one. We will see the wrong structure also. In this wrong one, so the sum of the substituents is first position chloro, and the fourth position second chloro, the sixth position the third chloro groups are present. So the sum of the carbon atoms is 11. So we should prefer lowest number. So here the sum of the carbon atoms, it must be low. So that's why this structure is correct and this structure is wrong. We should not give the numbering anti-clockwise direction. We should give the numbering clockwise direction. The sum of the substituents must get the lowest number. Next, we will see what are the three possible isomeric forms for the trichlorobenzene. Here, three possible isomeric forms are there for the chlorobenzene. that is 1,2,3 trichlorobenzene, 1,2,4 trichlorobenzene, 1,3,5 trichlorobenzenes are present. These are the three possible isomeric forms for the trichlorobenzenes. Next, coming to the substitutions per common name structures. For example, common name structures are there and substitutions are there. At that time, how we can write the IUPAC names? And in this case, the nitro groups are attached at the second and sixth position, that is ortho positions, and fourth position it is in a para position. So we can easily write the name. So it is in a toline. Benzene with CH3 moiety is known as toline. So here the suffix is toline, and we have to see the attachments. Nitro groups are attached at second position, fourth position, and sixth position. So we can write 2,4,6 trinitro toline. And when you see the second example, it is in a phenol. Benzene is attached with the OH group. The common name is phenol here. Then bromine atom is attached at the second position, fourth position, and sixth position. So we have to say it is 2,4,6 tribromo phenol. So when three or more substitutions on the ring, these are different. So at that time, the order of the numbering should follow alphabetical order. For example, in this case, to the toline moiety, bromine nitro groups are attached. So to the first, we have to write the suffix toline, and we have to give the numbering. This is the first carbon atom. Then we have to give the numbering. Next substitutions should get the lowest numbers. That's why I am giving clockwise direction numbering. And here 2 bromo, 4 nitro toline. And also we have to follow the alphabetical order. In the case of a second one, here there is no common name. So that's why directly I am choosing bromine, chlorine, iodine. Three substitutions are there. According to alphabetical order, we can write it. The first one is bromine, the second one is chloro, then third one is iodine. So these substitutions, where it will be attached, at which positions we have to check it. So the first one is 1-bromo, second position will be occupied by chlorine, 2-chloro, the fourth position will be occupied by the iodine. So we can write 1-bromo, 2-chloro, 4-iodine. These are the IUPAC names for the polysubstituted compounds. And next, coming to the aryl groups. So generally we know that methane formula is CH4. So whenever by the removal of the one hydrogen from the methane, we have to call it as methyl group. It is in a CH3. So likewise, arenes, benzenes are known as arene moieties. So from the arene moiety, by the removal of the one hydrogen, we will get the aryl. By the removal of one hydrogen, the resulting component is known as aryl. So these are the aryl moieties. At that time, how we have to give the numbering names? And for example, it is in a phenyl. So the benzene, by the removal of the one of the hydrogen atom from this ring, the resultant component is phenyl, and it is in a toluene moiety. So what is toluene means? Generally, toluene means benzene with CH3 moiety. So from the adjacent carbon atom, the hydrogen will be removed here. So it is known as ortho toluene. And from the meta position, one of the hydrogen will be removed, means we have to say it is meta toluene. From the para position, one of the hydrogen will be removed, means it is known as para toluene. Then coming to the aryl groups, the groups derived by removal of the hydrogen from the side chain are called as aryl groups. So for example, this groups also furnished by toluene. We will see here. From the toluene, the substituent here CH3, from the substitution, By the removal of one hydrogen here, by the removal of one hydrogen from here, the resultant compound is known as benzyl. And here, two hydrogens are removed, then it is known as a benzol. And in this case, three hydrogen atoms are removed and it is in a tertiary carbon atom. At that time, we have to name as in a ring, it is in a benzo. Likewise, we have to write the IUPAC names for the different compounds, that is phenyl, toluene, benzyl, benzol, benzo, etc. Next, coming to the fused polycyclic arenes. Fused polycyclic arenes are also known as polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. In shortcuts, we can say it is in a PAHS. Here, two or more benzene rings are share or two. Two or more benzene rings share two or more carbon atoms to be a part of PAH, polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. In general, name for this series is acene. It will be ended with the scene. For example, we will see the one of the example, pentacene. Penta means 5. Penta indicates the number 5. So, 5 rings are attached with each other. So, here angular fusion also gives the different components. The examples like here, two benzene rings are attached with each other. This name of the structure is naphthalene. If three benzene structures are attached with each other, the name of the structure is anthracene. And here the third ring will go upside of the second ring and it is in an angular fusion. It gives here also three rings are there, but because of the angular fusion, it gives the another component, that is phenanthrene. So these are the polycyclic arenes, fused polycyclic arene components. Next we will see the exercises. I'll give one structure, you have to identify the name. For example, for this structure, how we can write the name? And here it is in a carboxylic acid group, so the first priority we have to give the carboxylic acid. This is the first carbon atom, and the next carbon atom is this one. So to the first atom, the second next position is ortho position. We can indicate as an ortho position. The second substitution should get the lowest number. That's why we have to give the number in clockwise direction. And next carbon atom 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. So, you can write the name. You can find out the name now. So, it is an ortho nitro benzoic acid. Option D is correct one. Next, we will find the IUPAC name for the next one, that is this structure. And here the common name for this structure, you know that benzene is attached with the methyl group, it is in a toluene. And here to this substitution, we should give the numbering for one, and the second substitution should get the lowest number. That's why I'm giving anti-clockwise direction 3, 4, 5 and 6. So now you can easily find the name for this component, that is 3-bromo-toluene. The option is 3-bromo-toluene. And next, can you write IUPAC name for this component? Is it is 2-chloro-5-fluoro phenol. So benzene is attached with the OH group, it is in a main substitution, and here we have to give the first number, and the second substitution should get the lowest number, and also we have to follow alphabetical order. So that's why the chlorine will get the second position, then fluorine will get the fifth position. So 2-chloro-5-fluoro-phenol. And coming to the next next structure, and here I'll give two clues. The numbering is done to produce the smallest total, and also we have to list the substitutions in alphabetical order. So here the option is 3-bromo-1-ethyl-4-nitro-benzene. This is the correct one. So I given four options. Among the four options, this 3-bromo-1-ethyl-nitrobenzene is the correct one. So next I'll give the priority order also for easy preference. The carboxylic acids should get the highest priority, and when compared to esters, acid halides, amides, nitriles, means cyanogroups, aldehydes, ketones, alcohols, thiols, amines, arene are cyclic compounds, alkenes, alkynes, then alkanes, then ethers, then alkyl halides, and then nitro groups. This is the priority order. And the, what is the prefix we should use? What is the suffix we should use for these priority groups? We will see one of the example for this. If you see this structure, the cyano group, when here two functional groups are there, one is a cyano group and one is keto group. When you see this priority order, this cyano group, nitrile group, cyano group, then after that keto groups, after that ketone moiety, yes, the seventh one. So the highest priority group is cyano group. So the highest priority group as an A, we have to write suffix. The suffix name is nitrile. We have to choose the suffix name for the cyano group. It is nitrile. Then the lowest priority for the keto group, it is treated as an A substitution. So for this, we have to write the prefix name is oxo. For keto group, it is an A prefix name is oxo. So whenever it is an A suffix group, as in a primary group, at that time we have to write suffix name is one. Now here it is in a lowest priority group. Whenever it is lowest priority group, it is comes under prefix, then we have to write in a oxo. So the name of the component is 5-oxo-hexane-nitrile. So here it is the first carbon atom, then 2 and 3 4. This is the 5, 6. So at fifth position, oxo group is there, 5-oxo, and totally 6 carbon atoms are there. So we have to write hexane. The first position will be occupied by the nitrile group. We have to say it is 1-nitrile. Okay, or we can directly write 5-oxo-hexane-nitrile. This is the IUPAC naming rules for the benzene and its derivatives. If you like this video, subscribe my channel. And also click on the bell icon to get more notifications. Thank you.